Hi classmates, Becca Forsyth here again. This week we're being asked to think about our philosophical approaches to social justice. In our reading this week, Baroche explains that policy practices require the analytic capacity to respond to arguments stemming from these philosophical approaches. Equally important is the ability to communicate and argue without polarizing, rejecting, or demonizing those with divergent views. This last part is still a bit of a sticky widget for me, but I'm working on it. What is my political approach to social justice and where do I fall in the pack? As a member of the Democratic Party, I can say that we certainly are an unwieldy bunch of donkeys, aren't we? Marsh and Griggs explain that there is a split over party power, and I'm in the camp that is unhappy with the rigged system that is oppressing each and every one of us. I agree that no one on this grid has time for Donald Trump. I am in the postmodern camp that believes that justice is achieved when we find a fair allocation of the costs and rewards of group membership. I agree that all members of a society should be treated as equals, which falls far from the ideals of the current administration. I agree that everyone impacted by policy decisions should have a voice, which is why I'm going to DC next month. I also believe that no one is above the law and everyone should be treated fairly and equitably by the rule of law. What do these philosophical approaches mean for my advocacy efforts? They're the driving force behind my advocacy efforts. The kakistocracy that we have in place currently is considerably scarier than a simple oligarchy. I kind of wish we just had an oligarchy. That's the rich and powerful being in control. But the ones we have are the least qualified and the most unscrupulous. I believe that the time to fight for our rights is now. If we don't take a stand, our rights will continue to erode and justice, freedom, and the American way could be threatened. What are some advocacy skills that I have used that have worked? My work with the Poor People's Campaign has been focused on raising awareness of the inequalities that exist, the intentionality of the policies in place, and the intersectionality that exists between the various forms of oppression. We rallied in front of the local jail to talk about the criminal justice reform. We traveled to Binghamton, a city about 60 miles away, to stand against the injustices suffered by some junior high girls there who were presumed to be on drugs, so they were strip searched by school employees. We traveled to Albany to fight the Williams Pipeline, which was hugely successful. The governor supported the environmental justice and chose not to greenlight the project. What are my hesitations for getting involved in advocacy efforts? And describe a time when I might have had a conflict with friends or family. A lot of the work that I do involves speaking truth to power. It is hard. It's scary. It's intimidating. But it's important. I made a video where I raised some questions about our local hockey team and the culture of entitlement that surrounds them. They are very popular, and I was nervous about how my comments would be received. Not everyone agreed, naturally, but a lot more people agreed than I expected. It increased my confidence and has spurred me on. I also made a presentation in front of the New York State Energy Research and Development Agency, where I talked about the oppressive and unfair energy policies used by New York State Electric and Gas, and the impact that it has on the poor. There were three high-ranking NYSEG officials sitting just a couple feet away from me in a room with about 50 high-ranking energy policy officials that were gathered. It was terrifying, but I got through it. I did a pretty good job. And my offering was powerful, and I had the opportunity to give voice to the voiceless. It is scarier, but it gets easier each and every time. If we're going to walk with these clients hand in hand while we're in the therapy room, we need to understand what things are affecting them outside the therapy room. And these policies are a big part of that. So I really hope that we all get a lot out of this course this semester. Thank you.